family, we see craft in practice. Now, I really want to commend my brother Sonnetta. And yes, Sonnetta's still my brother. Don't allow this public disagreement to make you think otherwise. But his video wizardry, his editing skills are apparent in the reissue of the Nigga Frequency. Now, you say, well, Brother Larry, we heard your perspective. We saw the evidence. Nigga is ancient. No, nigga is not ancient. That is what happens when you present a one-sided view. See, you can game your way through anything. But if you let people game you into being niggas, guess where you gonna be? Where you at? You like this shit? Do you really like being niggas in America? This shit got a history. It ain't no mystery. They used to hang niggas on trees. They still do that shit in some places. And niggas don't do nothing about it. March, scream and shout about it. Hold up picket signs. And complain and whine. That's niggas. You see now, when you stop being a nigga, when you stop trying to defend being a nigga, when you realize that that is a plantation creation that does not exist anywhere else on this planet. You don't believe me? Let's take a look inside. When you look at populations of black people elsewhere in the world, what do you see? Do you see a difference between the black people elsewhere and the black people here who think they niggas, who have been forced to be niggas? Never mind that you have developed a style where you make being a nigga look good. Take a look at black populations elsewhere. When they talk about resolving issues through revolution, they pick up AK-47s and fire them shits. They marshal troops and form armies and march on shit, firing at shit. They don't fire off their mouth and videos. Really? I mean, take a look. Even populations of blacks as close as the island of Jamaica. Now, misguided as you can argue it may have been, what you cannot deny is that they picked up those guns in Trivoli Gardens and said they wasn't having it, and they was firing at troops. Now they got smashed because they weren't an organized military force with tactical training and deployment skills, defending their ground against a well-equipped enemy. No, they was just some black people different from the black people. Yeah. Now, we can talk about slave rebellions in 1831. We can talk about plots to rebel in 1821. We could talk about schemes to burn down cities in 1741. But what we can't talk about is niggas standing up and defending shit. Because niggas will stand there and watch your ass get drugged the fuck away by the police, by any white people dressed in suits and shit. They could just come snatch your ass, and niggas will watch that shit because niggas have it embedded in their minds that when they come and they snatch a nigga, that nigga did something wrong. That's the reason why they're going for him. He did something wrong. Otherwise, look around. They ain't bothering nobody else. See, that's how niggas have been programmed to think. That's plantation psychology being manifested just a couple of generations away into a social norm, into a construct that you seek to defend, that you seek to establish as something legitimate. That's not what it is. That's not what it'll ever be. You see, nigga doesn't have an ancient root. But the fact that you can edit a video, quote unquote, consciously and attempt in your endeavor to fight a battle against Brother Larry, attempt to make Brother Larry look wrong by making nigga look right, only means that your consciousness is misguided. It leads you in the wrong direction. It causes you to make the wrong choices, decisions about what you think is acceptable. See, I know you do not espouse what you purport to espouse by the editing of this video. But I did call you and leave a message on your phone, letting you know that I would be calling you a fake and a fraud, because in editing that video to make it look like nigga is somehow acceptable, that is contrary to black power consciousness. Because you know nigga is not black power consciousness. That is actually a tactic gone awry. You see, once upon a time, when populations of black people isolated in various regions of the South found themselves virtually defenseless. They didn't react to being insulted, because to react to being insulted would mean death, public humiliation, maybe even a violation of your family. And niggas would just stand and watch it happen. So now, coming away from that time and that fear, the black people at that time used the acceptance as a tactic to lessen the sting of the insult. Still an insult. Still meant as an insult. Even if you accept it, it only means that you accept being insulted. Now, there's a certain air of cowardice about accepting an insult. When you look at the other populations of the world, you don't see any other ones accepting insults. Rather, you see them picking up arms against a sea of troubles, and by opposing, ending those troubles. Now, I say it's time to make a decision. And I say that decision is to be or not to be. That is the question. Now, will we exist as a people? On the one hand, or will we just be a bunch of niggas on the other? Now, it's obvious. Brother Larry chooses the former. Brother Larry is not a nigga. Brother Larry cannot be defined by anyone other than himself. Brother Larry is trying to get a conscious understanding that we have to define ourselves and make that decision known to the world, so that the world calls us one thing, so that our children know themselves as one thing, so that we consciously consider ourselves one thing. Not niggas. Can't be that. Not that. But right now, courtesy of recent history, every black man, woman, and child can be called a nigger. Now, you say, we don't give a damn what they say. But that's where you got it from. You got it from them. So you do care what they say, because you are repeating what they say. And let me show you how you mean it the way that they meant it. Young girl, 15 years old, in conversation with another young girl, 15 years old. My nigga. Young guy, 20 years old, in conversation with another young guy, 20 years old. Sup, my nigga? Grown ass man. How old is Sarah Susan City? How old is that other light skinned guy? How old is this other guy? Nigga, nigga, nigga. And will attempt to justify this word by showing you words that they think may have sounded like this word in ancient languages that they do not speak, that have not been heard in thousands of years, that clearly have different vowel structures. And they want you to think that these words are nigga, just mispronounced by Europeans and therefore mispronounced by Brother Larry in telling you that you are not a nigga. You see, this is what happens when you accept the view of your conqueror. You see, when you internalize the view of another, you begin to think that you are what the other says that you are. Witness, Ethiopian. Now, how many people you hear claiming to be Ethiopian? How many brothers from the island of Jamaica will tell you that they are Ethiopian? Now, we know that Ethiopian is a Greek compound, mean burnt face, Ethiopus. Now, you know that we would not have called ourselves that. So you know that that's an external view. Now, you say, well, it's the name of an African country. In the 1800s, you had a ruler of a country called Abyssinia. He changed the name of Abyssinia to Ethiopia. In the 1800s, his name was Menelik II. So that country became Ethiopia in the 1800s. It wasn't Ethiopia before that. In ancient times, when the Greeks were talking about Ethiopia, they were not talking about the place that we see Ethiopia in Africa today. They were talking about India, where you see people who look like us in ancient times that had close contact with the Greeks. You understand? The Greeks at that time, they didn't have contact with the east coast of Africa like that. You see? The blacks that they had contact with, they eventually conquered. Yeah, Alexander. He marched into India. Now, my thing is this, right? We see populations of people all over this planet because we happen to be like the prototype of life on the planet. So most life on the planet looks like we do. I know this is kind of hard for some of you rocket scientists and scholars to grasp, but like you see different species of other life forms on this planet, and you look and you say, damn, there's a whole lot of them. They're like the prototype of species, like fish. Like other forms of life on this planet that have two eyes, two ears, a head, two arms, two legs, and a body. and run around. You understand? At some point in time, that model became functional, and because it became functional, it lasted. But there were other models before that. You understand? The planet is like experimenting with shit. It's still doing it today. That's why the planet still kill people. And that's not crazy spooky talk. That's tsunami water talk. That's earthquake talk. That's hurricane talk. You understand? The earth will kill you and kill massive amounts of you. Bangladesh 200,000. That type of shit. The earth will get you, right? If you're not smart. See, most other species on the planet, when there's some shit coming, they could like hear it, sense it. You see, they be hauling ass in the other direction, right? Man, with his intelligent ass, he want to film the hurricane. He want to take up close pictures of the hurricane. And the hurricane grab his ass and fling him. He want to go swim with the stingray. And the stingray sting his ass and fling him. He want to wrestle with alligators. You understand? That's modern human. You see, I'm from the prototype of man, not human, just man. And from the prototype, just man, I realize that there's a lot of different species of man that still exists, that because we share common traits, we kind of think we the same, but the earth don't play that shit. The earth changes shit in different places. There's different concentrations of gases and different concentrations of bacteria and animals and shit, different foods, different shit, different places. That's why people come up looking differently. But when you put them together, over time, you know, they start mixing and shit and start looking the same. You don't believe me? I can show you entire populations that's primarily mixed up people. You understand? Now, I ain't saying right or wrong about it. It's life. Life will find a way on planet Earth. We've seen that. It exists in cracks in the damn ground. My point is that most higher forms of intelligent life on this planet have developed structures of their own that they control, that they manage, that are reflective of themselves. And that they name, so the names of which is reflective of the people. Right now, because we have individuals who turn their brain power to proving that they are niggers, wasting valuable opportunity, wasting valuable time, and not really exhibiting a fundamental understanding of what a strategy is and how to implement one in order to achieve goals that you say you want to achieve. Right? Now, Brother Larry doesn't pretend to be a leader, and Brother Larry doesn't pretend to be a teacher. Brother Larry does, however, think of himself as a strategic thinker. And I can envision strategy in motion because I can deconstruct things as well as construct things. I can actually build. And the ability to actually build gives one a perspective where one can actually envision concrete structures and operations and movements of ideas through those structures and operations. And it's a different level of thinking. And that's all Brother Larry has ever said. It's different. Now, from my perspective, it's time to grow up. It's time to stop being little niggers. Start being men. We have work to do as men. And I'm pretty sure